Hallo, hallo, everyone. Let me open chat again. I want to see what you guys are writing. And then hello and warm welcome to everyone. I've had the worst of worst internet problems. I don't know if we are going to stay online, but I'm gonna try to stream. Let's hope for a good internet connection. Let me put morning. So issues today. First off, my desktop didn't restart in ages, so I had to restart the PC. Otherwise, I had to download an upload of about 100 kilobits instead of a good connection. And for some reason, our internet connection is going bad again. We've had those issues a couple of months ago, but our there was still no electrician coming around to fix the issue. Let's see. I hope you guys had a great day. Who's online? Order, Michael, Magic, NL, Flash, Marine is online, HVA. That's about it. Hello to everyone on Twitch and Steam too. I hope you're enjoying this Steam Summer Sale. With SimAirPod being reduced by on sale by 50%. Kyle, please don't do these issues, or I'll have to block you from adding new issues. We're not a kindergarten over here. more the toilets. What's that one about? That's a good first one to fix. Let me first get my stream deck back up and working. This is just a custom program for my stream deck. Might be never mind. I don't have the length of the cable to show you. Basically, it's a stream deck with custom programming to help me in the day-to-day business. Then I will need a second edition AirPod. I will need a PowerShell. go away. And of course, a Unity. Oh, right. I really quickly have to reset my license. Just 1 second. There you go. Let's just see. So, by what I gather from the issue, it will be pretty simple. I guess the toilet should now just cry around that it needs a toilet. And basically, the toilet is only checking for the base game toilet, not the actual component. Which means a modded toilet cannot be used. Well, that's usually a really, really simple extra check in. Zone, yes, that's not zone TS. And check requirements. Actually, rest. Yeah, as you can see, it just checks by name. Oh no, I changed code, so it's gonna reload. Should be easy. Once Unity is behaving. Let's see, let's first remove a bunch of them. Bathroom and then objects. Down, toilet. Not toilet. This should be working, but it's still saying toilet stall, as expected. So let's fix it. think it's a safe list here, so we have to check all of it. Actually, let's completely rewrite it. So any restroom needs at least a sink. If it's the female restroom, it needs the toilet stall or the toilet. The toilet doesn't matter anymore. That is, this component is gone. And it shouldn't matter. So it just needs a toilet stall. The male restroom needs a toilet stall. Or urinal. So basically we can use this same check for sink, but need a different check for the male and female restroom for toilet stall, and toilet stall is urinal. Let's see. Mother, if you can just reopen that one, I'll add the markers. Actually, did you ask for markers? Oh yeah, you did. Let me just reopen it. This part still stands, though. The jet base is just a graphic, it doesn't change at all. I'll add the markers for baggage carousel and moving walkways in a second. Let's just put all these checks together. We only have to run the list once. Thank you, CS. Yeah, I've got it's advanced over time now. The first stream was still pretty bad, but we've got some lights since then, and since I've got the lights up, even now when it's getting dark, we've got a good picture running. Even works with multiplayer people really well. If you look at the last stream we did together, so Arthur and me, you can actually see how we did two people besides each other. Interesting question now. It's possible the urinal doesn't actually... Yeah, the urinal is just a toilet utility. I don't actually have to check for urinal. So, in case if type non-type female. Actually, no, we can just, we don't actually have to separate the stuff now. If you know that urinals are the same as toilets with just one boolean, with just one field difference, that means we can use the same check for both. So return cached met is equal to found and there has to be at least one toilet and one sink and one toilet, and if both is true, then the requirement is met. Otherwise, return false. This should, let's just check, this should still work for the base game stuff, and then should also work for model stuff. Yeah, base game, all still working perfectly fine. Dismantle some stuff. There you go. It's slowly failing, but it's failing. Toilet stall / urinal. Now let's check that the mod works. Yep, there you go. So, chick, you can go ahead and get this one deployed. You may want to fix the graphics a little bit. Seems a little bit off. But maybe that's what you wanted to do. So. Let's commit it. Fix modded toilets and modded things not working. Actually, it's not. It's working fine, but it's the requirement was. Oh, whatever. Fixed with next edge deploy. Listen. No, Modder, you want the jetway, like I said, that's not available. Baggage carousel and moving walkway. no problem, Jig. Modder, are you good if I post you the base game versions and you take a look at those and extract the needed markers for yourself? Is that fine for you? Okay, perfect. I'll just post those through into the issue as a file. If you need any assistance with it, let me know. What did you want exactly? The package carousel moving. Okay. Utility. I think all three have the same config. Yes. It even checks whether or not it's the same level. It may also Ah, never mind. I thought at first it set the stuff specifically, but automatically checks whether or not it's on the same level. And it will work fine if you put it one level above or one level below. No, there is a portal inside, but it's just a fake portal, basically. It just says it just sets the input one level below or one level above, and that's it. Nothing more. So you can just use it, and wherever the consumer marker is, at that point it expects to be the same level, level down or level above. So if you set the consumer on the let's not change that. If you set the consumer on the same level as the object itself is, then it's the same level. If you set it below or above, then it's the same level. And it should just work. It doesn't set any sprites, so you have to set those yourself. And you need an additional sprite, so I will give you the... For the same level one, you don't need an additional sprite, but for the... From above and from below one, you can actually see the sprite appearing here. You will need an additional sprite. I will just give you this config. This one should have everything in it. What is JSON? And moving walkway. Moving walkway, I don't know if it will work as is. I will give you the config and you just let me know if it works or not. Maybe it's a bit special since it's a custom. Oh, never mind. Yeah, okay, so the moving walkway is a bit special. It will not get you the... Actually, yeah, the moving walkway, we'll have to move it back completely. We can't get it modded for the moment. I will need to change a couple of things on it. I will get you the baggage carousel though. One sec. Let's try and get it. File open recent, more editor lock. I don't want to replace it. Okay, same trick as last time. Select all. Control F for find. Place / n. Actually double / n to just / n. And replace all. Wonderful. Such magic. Much wow. And we want to save it. Repository configs. This one is bank dot JSON. It probably needs to be zipped again. Yeah. I will change this title now. Fix use if export. Oh, voll. So, just so I know that I can get the stuff fixed. Perfect. So you've got the baggage carousel config here, and I will take a look at moving walkways another day. Example for the zones and need PR to create an issue for further notice. No, PR is fine for BR. Just keep it in there. I will check it out. Elevator in general won't be possible for the moment. But 3x3 should work fine. Mod air, you can just move the marker one over. If you move the floor portal has two markers. If you move one over, it should just work. The auto foundation should just work. But it will still be problematic. It would still not be an elevator as is, but just a moving walkway. Not a moving walkway, but a staircase. I will actually close that one. I'm moving the markers, the right markers by one. Fix the auto foundation. The base will still be a case slash later. It works just for one level up. Yeah, it's basically just a staircase or an escalator. You'll have to just move the marker and it will still only work for one level. But at least if you move the marker, the auto foundation will correct. What is a big one? Someone's not working. The mod is set. FinFast, exactly. FinFast found. Once you have a second atlas, the floor is working correctly. I need to inflate my atlas. How big is it? Not even close to be filled. Let's just copy some big mods. Actually, just change one of the textures. Maybe not the used floor textures. Let's just change the parking. Image resize. Keep aspect ratio. And let's just say 4000. What's the max size on the atlas? Of course, perfect. This should basically take up half of the atlas. Which should mean we should be able to run into the issue really quick. I will have to delete one texture. Or just rename it. Yeah, whatever. You probably have so many texture mods, or mods in general, enabled that you actually need a second atlas. Doesn't need to change the name to get the mod atlas to rework, regenerate. Let's make sure we have a second atlas. Perfect. Yeah, I totally overblew this one. And all the text, all the new floors by mod air seem to be on the second one. Yeah, perfect. Now let's see. This should break. Floor 70. Let's use 72. Yeah, perfect. Instantly breaks. Ah, when the debugger doesn't work. Oh, okay. This is fixed, shouldn't be fixed. Yeah, model, that's the same problem. It's basically just set up for two texture atlases. Probably because we only had two. And probably, just guessing that the materials, pretty big list. In that moment. Let's see. Ellie. Hello, Estorado. Sorry if I'm butchering your name. This running once per frame. No, it's running once per change. Perfect. Or not. So it's just running once. We are attached. Let's get it to actually break on our breakpoint. Because that's what breakpoints are for. There we go. This one is probably the base game material atlas. This one is probably the first. It's not named, but I guess this one is the first modded atlas, and this one is the second modded atlas. What I want to do is, I don't want to just size. I hope the downstream works fine, but I don't want to use a fixed size, but material. This problem. Let's declare it somewhere else where it should be. And initialize it correctly. But count is equal to new into array with the size of materials dot length. So that for every material we put in, we have a word count size array. Let's see if it renders correctly. There may still be downstream issues, but it may just work. Hopefully. Once Unity is starting to react. There you go. Just to make sure, let's use another one. Works fine too. And another one. And another one. Do you have any walls in your mod air? Doesn't seem like it. They should work not fine too. So that's basically, that was basically all the issue. Just this small array not being the correct size for different material sizes. This stuff can happen, especially if you don't work on moddability from the start. In this case, we probably had two base game atlases for materials at some point, but since we could go bigger with the base atlas, we could reduce it to one, and it just worked with one modded atlas, because that's what was over, that was what the array had free in space. And we set it to. But as soon as we add another atlas, now we don't have a third index. It's just missing. And if you think about it, we didn't really, when we made it, we didn't really think that we needed a third one. So that's the point. Just so you guys understand why it was like this. I will commit it. Fix. Choose. Not showing up any more than one atlas is used. And close the issue. Things. Yeah. And plus this is the next edge version. This is a simple one. I talked to Marine about it. You'll just need to add an extra field for the masking. So basically, how does the base game, the scanner makes sure the trays aren't visible. The base game scanner has two graphics. One graphic is the one you can see. The second graphic is basically just this small part where the tray must be hidden and everything else removed. And we have an additional sprite renderer that specifically checks, is the tray at this position? And if it is so, then hide that part. The exact workings of it you have to read up yourself, because that stuff is deep inside Unity and done by Unity. We don't do it ourselves. But basically, wherever the mask is, wherever the Unity finds the mask, right? At that position, there's the tray is gonna be hidden, even if it's just partly. And the problem in this case is that those masks are pre-programmed, so you can't actually change them in the config currently. And that's what I'm just gonna add really quick. Let's see. At some point, yeah, there you go. So by default, it just gets the mask sprite. It just sets a mask sprite to scanner mask _, and then if it's remote large, otherwise just the facing. And we want to change this so that the config actually has a configuration for it. Yeah, Mod, yeah, that's that one will work too. It's basically the same. The trace being the wrong orientation is probably the space sprite being the wrong orientation, because the bin orientation or the tray orientation should just align with the whole back scanner. So if that happens, you may want to just turn around the sprite. Or just turn it by 90 degrees, not turn it around. So this is the default version. Mask sprite. Then that one is return sprite char.get. One's gonna be a bit easier. Can actually it's going to be the same, but instead of using scanner mask at the beginning, we will use the mask sprite. So for any modded backscanner, it's going to be whatever you set in your config, _. If it's a remote scanner, it's going to be the large _. Otherwise, it's just going to be _, and then the facing. So let's say, I'm missing a colon. Let's say you set mask sprite to mask. Simple, but whatever. Then it's underscore. Let's say it's a remote one, so it's a large underscore, and it's facing. Let's see, orientation. Let's say left. So it will be left. And this is the name you have to set the sprite to. Let's make it a little fancier and use it. Now just have to make sure that the master sprite is actually empty for the base game one, base game scanner. Yes, Modder. You can. Wait, I will show you. So let's say this is your belt on the scanner, and this is the scanner part. This is the going to be your the your main sprite, and for the mask sprite, what you want to do is basically remove anything where the sprite should be visible and leave only the scanner itself, and that is the master sprite. Oh, no wonder it didn't attach. No wonder it didn't break. Perfect. So for base game stuff, it's still the correct one. For modded stuff, it should work fine too. Committing it. Let's say add configurable masking. Scanner. I will close this one. Edit. To the back scanner utility. Mask. What did I name it? Mask or masked? Mask sprite. Let's do the name of the sprite. It should be for mask. Basic large automatic. For masking my mask the large back scanner to the left to the texture my mask underscore large underscore left. Usual texture. Just add it as the second texture, just like you add the first texture. You don't have to add it in the config, it's not an additional sprite actually. Just so you guys know, by the way, this one's short today. Pretty hot already. Let's also add it to the wiki, just to make sure it's not getting updated. Edit back scanner. Oh, It's remote, and it will be mask sprite. My mask. Cool, that one did it too. This one maybe want to get fixed. Or a short one at least. Let's add it first of all. Anything else to get fixed on a base? Ray tracing rotation, but that is not important. That should be an easy fix. But maybe done while we do the needs and zone stuff too. This one I will maybe do it in the next stream. Like it, maybe we can take a look at what the problems are with it. Might not be a too big problem. Polite is a hard one. I think I did fix this one, didn't I? Ah, perfect. I'll probably take a look at this one too. Which wall sorting? Modder, please just give me the issue number. That's the easiest for me. Why bake a chop? Seems to be working fine for me. Nope, working totally fine for me. Oh, yeah. Can you check if this one still is an issue for you? Problems sorting on back wall. Could you upload this mod? But I don't know why this one would fail to sort correctly. Because the vending machines should just work fine. The vending machines. Ah, we don't have sprites that... Ah, yeah, I see why this would work. Problem. we just don't have a sprite that looks like it. Yeah, just upload the mod for it, please. Could you try add? Could you just try to reproduce it? Just try to reproduce it, please, and upload the mod. If you have a second, this one too. It may be fixed with. Might have been fixed with some other. But as you can see, as you saw with me, it worked perfectly fine. Shoe mod. Let's remove all mods. except this one. Atlas, Atlas. Mod settings can stay. Yeah, this one is correct already. The issue is that even with just this one mod installed, the AR says it will say it's found twice. Why would it say it's found twice? We don't need to load any game, we just need to load the mods. So a new game would work fine. What is she detected? Yeah, that one doesn't matter. It was found twice, but why did you find it twice? Script handler. Restart, it should happen again. There you go, mod names should be empty, and this one should be as issue DLL with no subfolder. I've got an idea why it happened. Why did it jump? Thank you, Mutter. That's the XML file. The issue deal. Loading it. So we've got L initialize. Okay, so this should exit. Why does it load twice? Let's use the old debug log. Just to make sure it doesn't exist twice. Yeah. Actually, I've got it logged anyway. Don't have to add another logging. Yeah, I'm actually comparing the file name specifically to stop mods loading if you have it locally, if you're working on it, and if you subscribe to it. Because then you have the same mod twice, because you have the same, basically your mod loaded twice. Let's see. Loaded mod nameless from VR. I've got to take the stack off. I will have to add it. Logging. Ework.log. File. File. Let's just print what we load. Just want to see why or where it is called from it exactly. So yeah, for some reason it is actually loading the same DLL, the same path twice. It's exactly the same path. Flash, that shouldn't be an issue. This one is, this stuff happens even before the mod, or even, well, not even before, but it doesn't, it isn't dependent on that one. It doesn't matter. I think I know what's happening. No, never mind. Ah, okay. Yeah, I think I know what's happening. And I can only block it to some extent. Let's check the code. Yeah, so the issue is this these calls. basically, you cannot call basic pretty much anything that may in turn try to initialize mods. So what's happening in this case? What is happening? The early initialization is running. The early initialization will load all handlers. What does all handlers mean? It will load all handlers that can load early. This is basically just, I think, IE18N and mod loader, the script loader. Now you load the scripts. By loading the scripts, we load your mod. By loading your mod, we accidentally call IE18N, and by calling IE18N, it will call scene reset, which will in turn call the mod loader initialization, which will just do the same thing over again. And probably force IE18N to load first. Yeah, should be an easy fix. Can probably just load the item and handler early. Which should. It may not work. Let's test. Currently there's no real correct way to translate the name and stuff. I've made the issue to not set the name and description and all that stuff as a IATNN from the beginning. It shouldn't ever have to. It shouldn't have ever been a free text field. It should have always been an IATNN key, just like I've done with the setting stuff. Still font wise. What you can do on your end, just till this is fixed on my end, is not load it when the stuff is loaded. Actually, you don't really have a point where it's loaded correctly. You could change it to on load, but even on load happens before the IATNN gets loaded. So I'm just gonna force IATNN to load. Wait, even this one may not, even this may not work. Check. I think even this one may not work. Because it early initializes the mod loader before loading stuff. So yeah, you can't actually change it at all. For the moment, you will have to load it later. Let me check. Let's remove all this stuff. So the onload doesn't work. You can possibly. I fear we don't have an event for it. Load current culture, get current local, load. Load. Once. Nope. Yeah, I can do that on my end. I think that's the easiest version. Because in that case, that would also mean the it works over time. So if you change the currently, if you change the IATNN language, so let's say you start in English and then change to German, your mod name would actually not update. But if you change it around, so the UI gets the key, then it will work fine. And that's what I'm going to change now. Just need to figure out in which UI it's done. UI mod set, I think. Mm-hmm. Is it mod details? No, that's just thing utils. It's just the save games buttons. I can work with that. Entries. Game object. Nope. Actually, this one is just the VF related stuff. Ah, never mind. This isn't the in-game menu. This is the this one is not the menu for the players. This one is the menu for the mods from the main menu. Let's find. I'm just setting it here. Mod.name. Mod name to empty. If it's an N, right, get value. Mod name. Actually, mod.name. Out mod name. I don't actually have to create a new variable. Then actually if not equal to mod.name. So what does it do? If the try-get value works, then mod name contains the i18n version. If try-get value does not work, then we just set mod name to mod.name, and then for the display we say mod name. I can actually change the I won't actually change the mod on my end, because I'd have to put up a new Visual Studio. But it should work with the next Edge deploy. Let's commit it. Add ability ES mod name. We'll probably just really quickly, while I'm at it, do the same for the description. Ah, never mind, we don't have the description yet. It's not posted yet. Okay. And author is going to stay the same. We don't need a translation of the author, I guess. Add ability to UTS mod name. And key as mod name. Then in the issue, this one comes up whenever base game is called before mods have been initialized on may up. Workaround push with next edge deploy. Mod name can i18n key. So you can now change it to just the key. But the description just use a short description in English, and I will change it whenever we actually use the description. Okay, let's see, hashtag 70. Oh, perfect. Thank you for uploading this one, Maria. Let's see if we can get the sorting fixed in a timely manner. Let's see. Objects. just so you know, at Modair, this stuff will actually not, it's not really dependent on the direction you look at it. But it's not depending on specifically the back rotation. If you change the sprite for the front rotation to be offset into the wall, it would probably do the same. As a matter of fact, let's really quickly do that. I want to see that happening. Front. Curse. Sprites. You probably for the back thing. Right, yeah, minus 0.3. Let's just use the same for the front facing. Just to confirm what I already guess is happening. Which vending machine has a texture that is actually overlapping the wall? Modair. As far as I know, all the base game vending machines and other stands aren't actually on top of walls. Like the sprite isn't offset far enough down to have it happen. Yeah, as you can see, it's not usable, but it's still above the wall. All vending machines. Well, I kind of. I don't think you are correct on this one, but let me check. Vending machine. Ah, I see. This is a different thing. This is a different thing. As you can see, the sprite isn't actually moving. If you take yours, you can see your sprite is down a little bit lower. But if you'd use the base game one, it's not. The difference is not that the ordering is wrong, but it's just using a different system to... let me check. I think that may be a component. this is the drink vending. Drink vending. No, but it doesn't actually have a different component. But... Yep. I will show you how to fix that. Somewhat. You will have to move your sprite. Actually, let's see if I can fix it completely. Minus 0.3. Let's move it up to 0.0. Then again, minus 0.3. Move it up to 0.0. And then search for properties and number 9. If I can hit the 9. Let's restart. Oh yeah, by the way, we still have to get the life reload to work for placeables. We could work on that one too next time. Let's see. Okay, just to make sure, we should now have a sprite that is not hitting into the wall. Like this. This is correct. If you place it now, perfect. As you can see, you see the difference? What a, the sprite is somewhat slightly moved down, and it should happen for basically all sides. So let's see. Yeah. It's moved towards the wall. It doesn't happen on left and right facing, but it happens on front and back facing. And that is the same as vending machines. As you can see, by default, the sprite is in the middle of the cell. But as soon as you place it, it's moved up a little. Same with the bottom facing. You do that by setting the specifically the sprite back to zero on the Y. You don't try to move it yourself closer to the wall. Just have the game move it. For that, you have to move it back to zero on the Y axis on both front and back facing. Actually, the front facing I changed, so you only have to change the back facing. And then for properties at 9. 9 is attached to wall. That's the same thing that can be used for, or is used in the game for the bins. Garbage bins. I've already closed it, but you know how garbage bin attached to walls do. This is the same property. If you use 9, it will automatically do that. So move back to 0 and set property 9. I will also write it in the issue, just so you know, but I will not do any code changes on this one. Get attach to voice work, set the sprite back to comma 0. Okay. No change, no offset all. Then add the property 9 attach all to your properties in your view. Perfect. Let's see. Anything else may be able to fix in a big one. Page up upgrades, that's probably a longer one. Like this is a longer one. That one I'll have to check myself. Soon all vending have the same position, a big wish of many. No problem with that. Templates of airplanes are outdated. I will check that one out for the before I actually deploy this one. This one needs some longer changes too. Modded sites to work outside security. Oh, this one is actually... Oh, this one needs some fixes. The problem is I hard-coded the outside stuff. Maybe it doesn't. Let's see. Construction material. Can probably say public pool is workable outside. And then basically change a bunch of references. Actually, not too many. This will break a bunch of stuff because this is now a boolean. And for some reason... Why does this not fail? This should definitely fail. We can't really compare a boolean to a sidewalk. Let's see, can I get it to fail? Not really. Remove this. Some parentheses. Just to keep it clean. the sidewalk comparisons from everywhere because we don't use them, need them anymore. Ah, oh, never mind. Current is indoors and oops. I may actually want to check what I'm removing. Equals. The ones that are equal, we can just remove. This one we cannot just remove, we need to add a knot. Same with this one. At least the code is shorter in this case. Bye bye, Marine. And this should basically be it. Now we just have to say that our base game sidewalk does have this property. Which is a construction material and is sidewalk. There you go. Inspector and this walkable secure outside. Walkable, it should be walkable as is, and that is fine. And I think it should work. Do I have any test? Work. I will check it out more than in just a second. I have to test remote war gates. And that didn't work. You say hashtag CPA. I will check it out in a moment. Oh yeah. Of course. So previously I've checked if the current mat is sidewalk, but now I'm trying to access a field on the construction material. So I basically need one check, one extra check. I don't actually need an extra check, I just need a magic seashell. Basically, if there's no material at that position, we just expected, or we just use it as false, because that's how it worked previously too. If there's a null material, it's basically the same as, no, it's not usable for us. Previously, I just checked, is the current material sidewalk, and if it's not, if it one of them is null, it's just false. So we can use this check. So should work fine now. Let's see. Yeah, seems to be working fine because the gate is not throwing an issue. Let's just wait for the flight really quickly. It'll be coming around in the next half hour. And then we know for sure. Yeah, everyone deplaning and boarding perfectly fine. Cool. So you guys now can add custom outside stuff. This should also work for crosswalks as is, because the crosswalk config is used. So you should be able to add custom construction materials for outside that can be used to walk on, and add custom crosswalks to walk on. Cool. The commit will be add field for construction materials to be able to used outside secure to be able to be not used but worked on. Let's quickly add it to the wiki and close the issue. Added a to construction material and set to true to be behaved the same as the base game sidewalk. Close and comment. So have fun making some lovely outdoor sidewalks, chick. Just to be sure, you also want to add this to the wiki. And we have a site for construction material. Ah, never mind. I'm just blind. Edit. Add this one. Yep. Can this be used once? And the sector is safe. So I guess we'll be seeing some lovely new floor mods, which can be used outside, I guess. Okay, so real quick, last one. Need the window object config more markers. Does the object config for windows need more markers? Config specifically. Placeable. Oh, literally the vendor object. Let's see. If Vendor object. Any specific? Yeah, definitely. A couple, actually. Modder, I will give you the base game config on this one too, and you can copy those markers out of it. Just need to find out which the base game stuff the base game object actually uses it. I guess the bar, for example. Yeah, the bar is a vendor object. Cool. So export as JSON. I probably have to open the editor again. Open recent, more editor. All the way down. Shift, control, actually shift, and page up. And all the page up. Until we've got it all. Copy, double click, middle click, strgf, backslash n. By the way, strgf is just control in German. And replace all. N. Ah, never mind. I can't select everyone. Everything. Wait. Backslash N. Backslash R. Ah. Doesn't seem to want to find those anymore. Anyway, the repository config. This one is the bar. Dot. Can we please find backslash n? Doesn't like to find those. Probably with, yeah, once we enable regular expression search, it does. Please replace all. There you go. Close this one. Stop this one. And upload the bar.json .zip because GitHub. Just so you know, which markers are actually from the vendor object itself. The workers here. Workers here, the worker min, worker max, and I think that's it. Yeah, so these three, worker CR, worker min, and worker max. And the CR is the cache register, so that's where your cache, the worker goes to cache in, I guess. I don't know, to go to the cache register. And the worker min and max, that's just two points, and in that rectangle, the workers will run around. You can see the example of it in the bar JSON I've just uploaded. Okay, guys, any remaining questions? Otherwise, I'd say I'll end the stream for today. Shorter-ish one. But we still got a bunch of issues done. Let's see. Actually, this one isn't sorted by closing date. I don't know, we've got probably 4 or 5 done today. Yeah, I've got 5 commits scheduled. I will get these commits in as soon as possible, so you guys can get the mods up and running correctly. What did I want to say? Ah, right. As you've seen probably on the news post, if you haven't seen it yet, check out the news post we just published while this stream ran. We will be streaming on Wednesday, the 1st of July, this time together with Arthur. So if you have any questions about the game or just want to see gameplay, come by. We are going to be having a happy stream together. H-Wild, I wanted to ask about WarQuest. Did you see my video? What are your thoughts? I didn't see your video, but I can check it out and after the stream and let you know. If you could take a look into the examples or needs, yeah, and give me feedback next days. I will try VR. Can't promise you anything. I will check it out once I get the time to do so. And then we probably have to do some refactoring to get it working completely. Weeks, definitely. I will try to do it in the next days. Actually, if I do another stream next weekend and I haven't taken a look at it, just poke me and remind me for next week. Then I will check it out on stream next week. Okay, I'm gonna end for today. I've got a new fancy outro stream I can show you. And I will already say goodbye for the night. And I hope you guys come around for next time. And if you haven't yet, be sure to leave a like, subscribe to the channel, or follow Twit on Twitch. And if you're around on Steam with Sim Airport Board, please consider leaving a review. It's always the best help for us. Just leave a review if you haven't yet. It's a short thing for you, but a great improvement for us. If you know somebody, or know somebody who knows somebody, and who maybe wants to buy Sim Airport, give them a shout out. They may be allowed to annoy me if there's some issue. And I guess it's a good buy for 50% off. Anyways, I will see you all the next time. Hope you have a great evening, or morning, or afternoon, wherever you are. And bye-bye.